Isn't this also a question of politics? You have Vice President Duterte, Sara Duterte, who's so popular, and talks right now is they're using the ICC to silence her, in effect, weaken her politically, right? Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say hold her hostage. That's a bit too extreme, but weaken her politically, that's one. So is this administration also using the ICC politically in that regard?
I don't know about the administration.
Will it benefit President Marcos Jr. politically to rejoin the ICC?
Well, it will benefit him as president of all of the Filipino people kasi dumadami sa atin ang nananawagan yan the past 6-7 years since Duterte withdrew us from there. As for VP Sara, she's perfectly capable of weakening herself politically on her own. Palagay ko ginagawa na niya yan sa sarili niya at this point in time. But she's seen, as far as the issue is concerned, matagal na itong ipinapanawagan ng mga mamamayan. Ever since Duterte withdrew us from the ICC and the Rome Statute, mula nung nagsimula yung unang EJK, humihingi na talaga ng hustisya ang mga pamilya nila dito sa Pilipinas at sa buong mundo.
Okay.
So this is more than those politics. It's really about justice and accountability.
Okay, speaking of accountability, but I'll give you 1 minute to answer this. I know it's not fair. The budget. All right. Senate. I mean, this is a whole other program altogether. But the Senate already approved the budget. It's at 5.768 trillion pesos. Just holistically, do you have a main concern about this budget? I mean, you are in the minority, so I know you're one vote. You have specific issues. Mm-hmm, majority controls the budget. But what is your biggest concern, if any, with the budget?
Two biggest concerns, confidential and intelligence funds, and we aim to bring this to the finish line when Malacanang signs the budget. And I'll actively participate in the BICAM for this. So bantay na bantay dyan sa CONFI and Intel funds away from, you know, contingent funds even of OP to augment CONFI and Intel funds of civilian agencies na wala namang national defense and public safety mandate or expertise. And flesh out more yung spending ng ating budget para sa social protection. So, interest subsidy para sa pabahay sa mahirap, more personnel services ng Marawi Compensation Board at kahit sa special provisions lang, dagdag na compensation budget para sa mga biktima ng Marawi War. At syempre, mas maraming social protection doon sa Kalusu amendments in the Senate version para dito.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today,
you,
Senator Risa Ontiveros. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.